During our discussion, we will explore the prescribed guidelines and techniques for connecting the grounding electrode conductor in cases where the premises wiring is supplied from a grounded system. These regulations can be found in section 250.24 of the code, which pertains to grounding service supplied alternating current system. Hello everyone, welcome to the Codesultant channel. Section 250.24a mandates that a premises wiring system that receives power from a grounded AC service have a grounding electrode conductor connected to the grounded service conductor at each service location. The guidelines are outlined in sections 250.24a1 through a4. If the premises wiring is supplied by a service AC system, such as a single-phase 3-wire system, a 3-phase Y4 wire system, a high-leg Delta 4 wire system, or a corner-grounded Delta 3 wire system, the grounding electrode conductor should be connected at the service location. This connection should follow the guidelines outlined in 250.24A1 through 250.24A4. The connection of the grounding electrode conductor should be established at an accessible point, starting from the load end of the overhead service conductors, service drop, underground service conductors, or service lateral. This connection should be made to the terminal or bus where the grounded service conductor is connected at the service disconnecting means as per subsection 250.24A1. Let's consider an example. In an overhead service installation, the grounding electrode conductor connection should be made at a convenient and accessible point. This point is typically located at the load end of the service drop or service conductors, which includes components such as the weatherhead, meter socket, or current transformer enclosure. However, the specific location for this connection may require approval from the authority having jurisdiction due to the presence of a seal installed by the serving utility on the metering enclosure. Alternatively, the connection can be made within the service equipment enclosure, which is the most commonly accepted location by AHJs. In the case of an underground service, the grounding electrode conductor connection should be established starting from the load end of the service lateral or underground service conductors. Similarly to overhead services, the connection can also be made at the meter enclosure and service equipment. In addition to the grounding connection for the grounded system conductor at the point of service entrance to the premises, according to 250.24A2, if the transformer that supplies the service is situated outside the building, it is necessary to establish at least one additional grounding connection. This connection should be made from the grounded service conductor to a grounding electrode, either at the transformer itself or at another location outside the building. This means that a grounded service to a building must have the grounded conductor connected to another grounding electrode at the utility transformer. Away from the building, this requirement ensures that the electrical system is grounded at two points: the source transformer and the service disconnecting means. Service utilities typically adhere to NEC rules and ground their electrical systems. However, they do so for a different reason: compliance with the National Electrical Safety Code, NESC. According to Section 250.24A3, in the case of dual-fed services, where two power sources are connected in a common enclosure or separate enclosures with a secondary tie, it is permissible to have a single grounding electrode conductor connection to the tie point of the grounded conductor from each power source. In the depicted illustration of a dual-fed system with secondary tie points, a single grounding electrode conductor is connected to the tie point of the grounded conductor for each power source. Section 250.24A4 specifies that if the main bonding jumper, as stated in Section 250.28, is a wire or bus bar connecting the grounded conductor terminal bar or bus to the equipment grounding terminal bar or bus in the service equipment, the grounding electrode conductor is allowed to be connected to the equipment grounding terminal, bar, or bus linked to the main bonding jumper. The provided image depicts a neutral and grounding bus terminal in a low-voltage switchgear. In this configuration, a bus bar serves as the main bonding jumper. As per the specified rule, it is allowable to connect the grounding electrode conductor to the equipment grounding terminal, bar, or bus that is associated with the main bonding jumper. Thank you all for watching.